Hello and welcome back to this Machine Learning and AI for Beginners series. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to train custom machine learning models using Model Builder inside of Visual Studio. Now, in this video, you're going to learn a few things. You're going to learn what Model Builder is, what you can do with Model Builder, and I'm going to guide you through a sample showing you how to use Model Builder to train custom machine learning models. As a reminder, any samples of code that you see in this video, you can find them over at aka.ms/dotnet-ai-beginner. Let's take a look at some code. As you can see here, we're inside of Visual Studio, and I have a class library project here that's available to me. Now, to access Model Builder, we just right-click here, go to Add Machine Learning Model, and then what it's going to do is it's going to ask me to create this machine learning model artifact. Right now, I can just type in the name here. And what this is going to do is it's going to generate an mbconfig file. Now, I have one here ready. So let me just open that one up. And so Model Builder, it is a Visual Studio extension that helps you train machine learning models, inside of Visual Studio. In terms of what you can do with it, there's actually a variety of things. But mainly, it's training custom machine learning models. And there's a variety of scenarios that we have available here. So for example, you're going to see this tabular section here. That typically contains scenarios that use classical techniques like logistic regression, recommendation algorithms, so on and so forth, to accomplish those specific tasks using your own data. All right. And so you can see those up here. We also have a few deep learning scenarios, such as these computer visions. In the computer vision section here, we have image classification and object detection, as well as for language, we have text classification and sentence similarity. One of the other things that you're going to notice is that for some scenarios, we have local environments, right? Which means that you can train these custom ML models locally on your PC. And in some cases, you also have the option of choosing Azure and leveraging the Azure Compute and the Azure sort of ecosystem to train some of these machine learning models. Okay. Now, in this case, the scenario that we're going to be working with is trying to apply labels to a set of GitHub issues. And so with that in mind, the best scenario for us to choose here is text classification. Okay, so once you click and select text classification, you're going to be asked to choose your environment. Now, text classification is only available locally, but one of the things that you'll notice is that in addition to training on CPU, you also have the ability of training with your GPU locally. All right. Okay, so once you select your environment, I'm going to go over to data here, and you're going to see that you're going to have the option to choose your data set. In this case, it's this issues train TSV file. And you're going to see here that it's also going to let us choose what the label or the thing that we're trying to predict is, as well as what the text column or what are going to be the inputs to this model that are going to help make the prediction of what the area is. And so you can see from this drop down, I can choose that column. I can choose this as well. And then you can see a quick preview here of what this data looks like. Now, once you're comfortable with the way that your data looks, you can go over to the train step here. And then if I was training for the first time, you would see a button here to train, which would kick off that training process. And again, during this process, what's going to happen is it's going to use, at least with the text classification scenario, it's going to be leveraging the TorchSharp set of libraries, right, which are .NET bindings for the libtorch library. And it's going to fine-tune a text classification model using my data. And at the end of the day, it's going to end up with a custom machine learning model that, again, is tuned for my particular data set. In this case, it was that GitHub issues data set. Okay. And then once the training is done, you can see that there's going to be a few metrics here. For example, the macro accuracy, that's kind of the metric that we're using to measure this particular model. And you see it's a 0.58. So for demo purposes, this is fine. And then for training time, you can see how long it took to train this model. And in general, it just found one model here. Now, what you're going to see here is that in the mbconfig file, there's a few artifacts that are generated. There's this consumption, mlnet, and training.cs files. Now, the GitHub issues.mlnet file, that is our actual model. Again, this is a serialized version of the model that gets generated once training is complete. For the training.cs file, I'm just going to sort of go here to the main section. Is there's a whole bunch of helper functions that if you wanted to retrain your model on new data using the same pipeline, you're able to do that, and we give you the code for you to do that through Model Builder here, right? And you can see that this is the actual set of steps and transforms that were used to train this specific machine learning model. If we go over to the consumption side of things, you can see that we generate a few data objects here for you that represent your particular data set. And again, very similarly, we also generate a set of helper functions that help you consume the model or make predictions with it. Okay. One of the other things that you can do once your training is done is you can move on to the next step, which is the evaluate. Now, as you can see here, there is a way for us to input the title, which is the thing that we're using to generate predictions or to apply labels to these individual issues. And so if we were to sort of, you know, write something out here, directory.getFiles should load files from remote source, and we can predict here, this is going to go out to the model and actually try to generate predictions for us. And as you can see, this particular issue, the model believes that it belongs with a, you know, high chance or 78% chance that it belongs to the system.io area, right? Which I think in general, given the API that's mentioned here, right, it's fairly accurate. Okay. In this video, we took a look at a few things. You learned what Model Builder is, which is a Visual Studio extension that helps you train custom machine learning models. You saw that with Model Builder, you can train a variety of different models depending on your scenario for your particular data set. And we also took a look at how Model Builder can help you train these custom ML models. Specifically, we took a look at the example of using it to train a model that predicts labels for GitHub issues. In the next video, we're going to take a look at how you can take the model that we just trained here, test it out, build a consumption application, and deploy it to Azure. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.